Yeah, it was an exciting moment for me. I mean, as to say, as a Real Madrid supporter, and to make my debut against them was like, you know, I feel like a dream come true. I mean, when, you know, I was expecting to make my debut, but not against this team, you know, and when coach called me to get warm and to come on the pitch, you know, it was just it feel like a dream, you know, to come on the pitch, to see players on the same pitch as players like Benzema, Modric, Vinicius, you know, it just was a crazy feeling for me.
What do you think this opportunity and this experience that you had, what does it say about, you know, kids that have dreams and want to go after their dreams? Because it's a classic example with you.
Just to never give up, you know, with football, life could change in 1 year, 6 months, you know, because football is go fast, you know, because to be honest, I never gave up. At times I feel to give up, you know, not because you have a bad game, I think it's the end of the road, it's not the end of the road, it's just, you know, I had to keep going and moving forward because I could have given up so many times, you know, and I just keep pushing, you know, because bad days are just make it, you know, and I just keep pushing and yeah, just to reach in our Champions League and playing against Real Madrid in the Bernabeu and winning on our last minute is just unbelievable.
I know, I could just imagine. Tell us about that moment though. I mean, from the moment you saw the ball enter the net, was a screamer as well. The goal was fantastic. You know, what was the emotions like? What was it like being on the field there? And I'm sure it would have been pretty surreal.
Yeah, I mean, I came on as a left winger, on as a left back, but I came on as a left winger. And then, you know, the player who get the ball I think he's the most technical player on the team, so I knew he was going to shoot. I mean, didn't expect it to score, but when the ball hit the net, I was a little shocked for a moment, and like 2 seconds after, we had to go and celebrate, you know, because I was shocked myself, you know. And it was just, you know, pause, reason, feeling, you know, to win the match. In that time of the game, you know, against Real Madrid was surreal.
And what was it like for you, you know, in the moments leading up to the game, obviously getting to the stadium, the warm-up, you know, you in this venue, and we made it, you know, we described it as, you know, you having an opportunity that millions only have that opportunity of experiencing it via the television screen or the FIFA video game. And here it was, you actually living that experience. You know, what was it like, the warm-up and then stepping onto the field, you know, the teams walking out, etc.?
Yeah, I mean, from the warm-up, you know, I mean, I warm up with the team, the starting team, because, you know, hopefully I would have come on the game and stuff like that. So, you know, from the warm-up, you know, it was just, you're warming up, but as I mean, you're thinking behind your head, you know, is when you see this thing on TV and, you know, PlayStation, you know, playing the Bernabeu, you know, and you're warming up, but, you know, you stay in focus at the same time, you know, from coming on from the starting, coming on the pitch to watching the pitch, you know, just keeping focus. You know, we know it's a big moment, but we also have to stay focused because any day is we on the field and them on the field, you know. So we think, you know, to ourselves be on the same level, you know, if they could be on the field with us, they're on the same level with us, you know. And we just went out there and, you know, coach tell the players what to do and we stick to the plan, and yeah, I think we executed it well.
I have to ask you, were you able to exchange shirts with anybody after the game?
So yeah, I get David Alaba shirt.
Ah, fantastic, fantastic. Do you have the shirt that you can show us?
Yeah, I've got it here. I still have a shirt though.
That's okay. Let's see it. Fantastic, man. Fantastic. So that one has to be framed and put up somewhere in there, right? Or you're sending that one back to Trinidad? That one coming, guys.
Yeah, that one coming. I don't even watch it.
I can't imagine.
He also take mine on.
All right, fantastic. And I can imagine the scenes after the game as well in the dressing room for you as a young player from the Caribbean, being able to experience that, and then obviously going back to your city, to Tiraspol, to experience it or to enjoy it with the fans.
Yeah, I mean, after the game in the dressing room, you know, everyone was, you know, shocked, but still we believe that what we done, you know, and everyone was just, yeah, one of the most craziest after dressing room moment I ever had, you know. Everyone was proud of us. Even when we come back here in the airport, you know, everyone showed us plenty of love, you know, and happy for us, you know, because I mean, we not only then went to the Bernabeu and play, you know, we went and win, you know, so yeah, the city, everyone just really happy.
And were you able to brush shoulders or at least get some acknowledgement from some of the other Real Madrid players after the game, the usual handshakes after the game, Benzema possibly, and some of the others?
Yeah, I shake hands with Rodrigo, Modric and Alaba, I think. I mean, there were the other players was angry, I think.
Yeah, I can imagine, yeah, because that would have been such a shocking defeat for them. And you know, this is not a regular game. This is UEFA Champions League you're talking about, so everything counts.
Yeah.
Now the pressure is on the club a little bit, you think? I mean, two wins in two matches, you're all in the driver's seat. But now is to try to be consistent and see all the rest of the
team. I mean, yeah, we're trying to be consistent. I mean, as people say, you know, people think that, yeah, starting at the group stage, Sherrif, yeah, everybody take these 3 points, you know. And I think now that people can show us a lot of respect, and, you know, I think matches would even be harder, you know, because now teams know that we can play football and, you know, we come to win and not just participate, you know. And I think games will get even much harder, like now on the 19th and next month, we have to play against Inter Milan in Milan, which is going to be a really tough game. But yeah, as I say, as coaches tell us, you know, they are the big teams. They are under pressure. We are not under pressure. Just go out there and play football. And I think it's them things that they tell us is make us more or less stress, you know, and we'll just go out and play our football.
Perfect. And what message would you have for Trinidad and Tobago, the people who are looking on and seeing one of ours out there representing them, and, you know, a message for other people who will, you know, hopefully be inspired by you?
No, it's just, just Keston from Trinidad, you know, playing in the Champions League, you know, trying to make Trinidad proud, trying to fly the flag high, you know, not trying to disappoint people. And I mean, they have disappointments in life, but not trying to disappoint, you know, and just trying my best to do my best every game, you know, even, you know, it's hard to get back into the starting lineup right now because our team playing fantastic, but, you know, I try my best every game, you know, waiting for my moment again to get back my starting pick. And I think it will come soon. And when it come, I'm hoping to see my position.
Keston, we want to thank you for this opportunity. We want to wish you all the best from all of us here in Trinidad and Tobago, and we'll continue to you know, root for you and wish you and your team all the best. Thanks a lot. Finisher, but I could imagine for you, bro, I think, like, you probably still feeling as though this thing is like a dream.
Yeah, for you, but I tell, I come on there and it's like, I mean, it's 1-1, but, you know, Coach Kyle go and he said, Keston, just defend, you're going another winger, but, you know, come like a back five, you know?
Yeah.
And just different. If you could go in attack, but I still come on there and I think, and I'm going about, you know. And so just seeing them fellas, you know, like Alaba and Militao and, you know, these players, Valverde. It was just, I mean, like when I was warming up, like Modric and Cruz were warming up right next to me, you know. And I warming up, but I'm not trying to look starstruck, you know.
Yeah.
But I just watching the fellas, like I play with the fellas on FIFA, you know.
I can imagine.
These players win World Cup and 4 Champions League, and I think it was just a real incredible feeling.
But I'm sure, you know, at the end of the day, you realize everybody is human. You know what I mean?
Yeah, for sure.
We're playing field once you're out there with them. So.
Yeah, I mean, everybody's human, you know, and it's just football, you know, but there are these big players right there on the same pitch, you know, and we're just trying to get the results.